Welcome to System Sailing. I'm Wally Cross. Today I'm on Tom Ritter's J70 to talk about boat handling in system sailing. The equation of doing really well in sailing, in racing, is first to have really good boat speed, really good boat handling, and then good decision making. And the truth is if you're fast and you have good boat handling, you're going to look pretty smart on the race course because you're going to be going well, you're going to be sailing solid, and you'll be able to hang with the top groups. Of course, making good decisions will finalize that complete puzzle of winning, but the first two are really important. So today, let's talk more on just the boat handling and how to get around the race course and maneuver your boat as smooth as possible. Within system sailing, we're always using numbers, particularly in boat handling. For example, I'm on the J70 right now, and it's usually a team of four. And if we're sailing upwind, before we're tacking, the helmsman or the tactician will be saying tacking in 3, 2, 1. Those numbers all mean something, and they mean something different depending on the wind speed. Example would be in light air. If the helmsman or the tactician says tacking in 3, 2, 1, that cadence of 3, 2, 1 is the rate the helmsperson should turn the boat. If it's windier, it might be tacking in 3, 2, 1, and then that should be the rate the boat turns. But back to the light air and the J70, we're tacking in 3, 2, 1. So for example, if it's light air in a J70, we might have two people in the cockpit right where I'm at right now. The main trimmer would be to windward, the helmsperson would be to windward. And if we heard tacking in 3, the first thing we would do inside the boat is move to leeward. Moving to leeward heels the boat more, and it makes the boat naturally want to turn up into the wind. So at 3, we'd be to leeward. At 2, we'd still be to leeward. And then 1, as the boat's turning, we would all come to windward, which will eventually be the new leeward side. But we'd all come to windward to actually roll the boat to windward as the boat's turning. We would back the jib just a little bit so it's not luffing, and the main traveler would be pulled up all the way to windward from the leeward side. All four of us would remain to leeward as the boat tacks. And then out of that tack, the boat would have a lot of heel. So the next numbers we would hear would be flattening or rocking. There's two different words. They both mean the same thing in 3, 2, 1. And so at 1, the whole crew would come to the new windward side. The boat would flatten and accelerate because as the rig pulls to windward against the wind, it's actually pushing the boat forward. And then as the boat flattens completely, then the two of us that were in the cockpit before would come back in the cockpit so the boat could sail at the proper heel angle. I mentioned that those numbers mean something in different wind speeds. In heavier wind or more wind, when the crew's on the rail, tacking in 3 means just heads are inside the lifelines. 2 means just be prepared to tack. And then 1 means the boat's turning and it's time to just get across the boat as quick as possible while letting the jib go on one side, trimming it on the other, and then hiking back out. On bigger boats with a lot of crew, sometimes, and when I call out those numbers, tacking in 3, I actually like to have the crew at 2 start moving to leeward, using gravity because the boat's heeling, to get to the new windward side before the boat turns. So once the boat is on the new proper tack, the crew's already hiking out. It's a quicker way to get across the boat, and the end result, having the crew hike at that time, is really valuable. So as a team, your team, you should just go out and practice and always be using the 3-2-1 cadence and kind of describe to everyone everybody's role in those different numbers. And then when you're back at the dock and you're evaluating your day, your practice, or even your race, you can decide, did it make sense for all of us to leave at 2? Or was that too early? Should we leave at 1? Should we rock at 3, 2, 1, or should we make it a little bit longer because it's choppy? It's your system. I'm just trying to give you an idea how it can work. So we know the numbers work when tacking, and they work extremely well also off the wind when you're jibing. For example, if you're sailing downwind, again, on this J70, you probably have one of the crew to leeward. You'll have the spinnaker trimmer, the asymmetrical trimmer to windward. The main trimmer might be also to windward, as well as the helmsperson. Yet if the boat gets too flat, the main trimmer might move in the boat. But as soon as the command is made to jibe, the helmsperson or the technician says jibe, and in three, the whole crew would come to windward. And what that does, it just allows the boat naturally to want to turn to leeward. The less the helmsperson uses the rudder to change course, either upwind or downwind, the faster the boat's going to accelerate out of the jibe or tack. So using the crew weight to turn the boat is a big, big advantage. So in this case, at three, the whole crew's to windward. At two, the whole crew's to windward. And at the one, the boat's jibing. The asymmetric comes across first, the main comes across second, and now we're on the new jibe with everybody to leeward with a lot of heel. Then the next command is rocking or flattening in 3, 2, 1. The whole crew would come to windward. The helmsman would not change course at all. That again, that flattening just accelerates the rig into the wind. The boat sails faster, and once the boat's really flat, then two or one, however many it takes, move back in the boat to get the proper heel angle. Again, it's something you need to practice. Those numbers are different relative to the wind speed. You know, in heavy air, you're gonna get across the boat sooner to flatten than you would in light air. A lot of times I'll always say, watch the boom come across. Once the boom's coming across, that means that's your clue you're gonna be coming across to flatten the boat, still using the numbers. Other things to do regarding boat handling using numbers is that when you're at the top mark or at the bottom mark, whenever you're rounding a bar mark, we use numbers all the time to do two things. One, talking to the crew on how to move their weight to help again turn the boat at the top mark more off the wind, at the bottom mark more upwind. And then also on the hoist, what the numbers mean when the kite or the spinnaker or the asymmetric's going up or when it's coming down. For example, let's say we're sailing to the top mark in a windward leeward course, and we do have an offset leg. So once we get to the top mark, someone might say top mark in two boat lengths. And once we get to the top mark, someone might make the command hiking in 3, 2, 1. And what happens when everybody hikes really hard around the top mark, as the helmsperson slightly laying off, the boat not only accelerates, it naturally turns to leeward a little bit with less rudder angle. So once the boat's sailing on the offset leg, now the next goal is to round the offset mark and hoist the asymmetric or hoist the spinnaker. The real goal of that offset leg is to figure out the best course so your boat can have as much momentum or speed at that offset mark as possible. And often I'll encourage people and teams to sail more of an arc direction than a straight line direction. So once you round the windward mark, instead of aiming right at that offset mark, it's okay to take your time as long as there's not a lot of boats around you and sail more in an arc fashion. So you're always building your apparent wind speed as you're turning down. Because what the goal is at the offset mark is to take that momentum, that speed of your boat, and to use that to really sail lower than you would sail normally with the kite up or with the asymmetric sail up while that sail is being hoisted. So that once it is hoisted and you're at the proper truant angle, you've really set yourself up a little lower than normal, which is helpful when you want to jibe quickly and someone in front of you or protect from someone behind you. So let's just say, for example, we round that offset mark, and now we're sailing. If our proper true wind angle number is 145, I'll encourage the helmsperson to steer the boat more at 155 while the sail's going up. And then what we do with the spinnaker hired is we'll have three marks on it. One mark when it's fully hoisted, 6 feet down from that, we'll make two marks, and then another 6 feet down from that, three marks. So when the mast person is pulling the sail up, as soon as he sees the three marks, he or she will yell three, and that alerts the helmsman to start turning the boat up to get closer to that proper two wind angle number. At two, either the jib should come down, Genoa should come down, or the sail should get furled. And then at one, the jib should be down, the boat should be at the proper two wind angle number, in this case 145, and then the spinnaker sheet or asymmetrical sheet should have a mark, and that trimmer should just hang on to the sheet until that sail fills. Now the boat's sailing efficiently at the lowest possible angle it could, because you've used that momentum to stay down and to stay on course. Now let's talk about the bottom mark. Sailing downwind, we've jibed, we've done a good job getting to the bottom mark. And to come into the offset leg, the gates at the bottom mark, we're gonna decide when to take that sail down. Again, we'll use numbers in this case. 3, 2, 1, dropping the kite. But before that, the jib or the genoa is gonna go up or get unfurled. And then at the proper time, usually a little bit outside 3 boat lengths, you're gonna be dropping the asymmetric. So 3, 2, 1, drop. And once that sail's down, now it's everybody's job to think about how to get around this mark, not only efficiently, but in the best angle. And usually the best way to get around the leeward mark is to give that mark a lot of space, sail away from it as much as you can while you're sailing downwind. So then when you're turning towards the mark, you're sailing at a close hauled course, as close to the mark as possible. But in order to do that effectively, you need the crew to help turn the boat. And again, on a J70 like this, what we've asked the crew to do is just lean to leeward. Make the boat heel more than you would normally when you're sailing upwind, because that'll naturally turn the boat up without too much rudder angle. So as we turn around the mark, with the crew's heeling to leeward, the sails are trimmed in, the helmsperson's getting the boat as close to the mark as possible. Then we'll say hike in 3, 2, 1, the crew will come up from leeward, go out and hike, and now we'll be sailing a high lane as fast as possible. Again, other areas you're gonna use numbers in boat handling is at the start, the pre-start. We'll talk about a system for starting down the road, but for example, my system always starts at the warning gun at 5 minutes, you're on starboard tack aiming for the pin. Yet telling the crew that based on where we want to start on the line, we're going to be coming back at 3 minutes for the boat end, 2 minutes for the middle line, 1 minute for the lower end of the line. In this case, let's say we want to start at the upper end. At 3 minutes, we'll say tacking in 3, 2, 1. We'll tack back to port, aiming towards the boat, looking for a hole that we can tack to in that upper third with about a minute to go. And again, we'll use the numbers. Here's a boat coming here. We're going to tack to leeward him in 3, 2, 1 to alert the crew, to alert the helmsman that not only we're tacking before that boat, but that's the rate of the turn. And we may lay off, aim at a boat that's trailing us, or we may then after we tack and complete our tack, which you have to do, start luffing up to make our hole or make that distance between our boat and the leeward boat as big as possible. And then the numbers that come into play at that point are not only the time, but also the distance from the line. And assuming you'd be using a starting tool like Velocitech, there's a variety of them that give you the distance from the line once you ping each end. The combination of time and distance will alert the team when to trim in and lay off. And just as we did at the leeward mark, we'd have the crew all pushing their weight to leeward on a J70 if it's light to moderate air. The heel of the boat move a little bit more as we're laying off, so that as we turn up at the gun, the boat naturally wants to come up, and then the crew would come to windward, flatten the boat. And the whole goal on a start is to get up to target speed as quick as possible before you start trying to sail high and hopefully get rid of the person or the boat to windward of you. So in system sailing, as we said before, numbers mean something. They relate to something. And in boat handling, they mean how the team works together. Unlike when we talk about communication, where there's 3 separate teams, you've got the speed team, information team, and the mechanical team. When it comes to boat handling, the numbers keep the whole team together working as a group, a whole group. And when everybody moves and works as a group, not only does the boat turn more efficiently, the boat, the end speed, the net speed after the maneuver, regardless of tack, a jibe, top mark, bottom mark, or start, is going to be better. And your results will reflect that. So again, boat speed, we've got that. We've talked about that. Boat handling, that's what you got to practice. You need to go out and practice this, because if you perfect it as a team, you'll remember it, and it'll really become one of your stable horses to make your boat fast. The next time we talk, it'll be about decision making. Again, this is Wally Cross for System Sailing.